Please close your eyes. All of you have already, you are all familiar with the subject about yourself, name it God if you choose. For the first few minutes, we shall sit down quietly, so please close your eyes, relax. And one verse, today being Dasara, when the Devi's puja worship, I will chant that and you can, I'll tell you the meaning of it and you just see the meaning of it, be with it, that is meditation. Yadevi sarvabhuteshu sarvarupena sansthita namastasye 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 namo namah. Yadevi sarvabhuteshu sarvarupena sansthita namastasye 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 namo namah. The meaning is Devi. The word Devi, Deva, both masculine and feminine, come from the root, that which is Dyotanatmakam, which is shining. Dyotanatmakam Devam, that which is shining at all times, in all places, in all conditions. And you are aware of this dimension. Vardhita is something which shines at all times, all places, in all conditions, eternally effulgent. Surely, it's not the sunlight, the sun shining outside, or the moon shining in the night. It is not your eyes shining all time, or even your thoughts passing at all time. Every one of these things come to an end. The light of the sun, the light of the moon will have no meaning when the eyes are blind. The sun may shine, but will not shine for you. The eyes are blind. The eyes will shine only if there is mind behind it, lost in your thoughts. Your eyes do not observe, see anything. So they shine for some time and then fade away. In fact, they are not self-shining. The sun shines because your eyes are shining. Without your eyes shining, the sun may be shining, but you don't have any idea of it. the eyes will shine. If the thoughts are behind, withdrawn to your mind, your eyes lose to perceive. The thoughts are shining because you shine, you are conscious. And you shine because you shine. There is no reason for your being effulgence, shining at all times. And that is Dyotanātmakam, shining at all times. Sve Mahim Nirajati, shining in its own glory, own Mahima. Shining all times, Dyotanātmakam. If you name it Deva, is masculine. If you name it Devi, it is feminine. That is the nature of everybody. Whether you like it or not, want it or not, accept it or not, your sense of being, non-negotiable, ever existing at all times. That Devi, Ya, who, Sarvabhuteshu, Sarvarupena Sansthita, Sansthita, Samyakstita, existing in all its glory, in all its manifestations, in all the beings, in all the forms, in every possible way. Your body is young or old, masculine or feminine or neuter, healthy or sick, whether it is a dust or a galaxy, a leaf or a forest, a drop or an ocean. In all forms, the same consciousness, awareness alone is existing. Shining in all its glory. So you look at yourself from your childhood until now, from the childhood of your body, to the aging physical body. In all these changing, aging condition, you are eternally shining. Your sense of being, ageless, changeless, deathless, eternal effulgence. As I mean, it is true for you, in your body, in your sense organs, perceptions, sensations, thoughts. It is same in all the beings existing in this universe. Everything is divine. This Devi Mahatma, this Devi Saptasati, in 700 verses on Mother. They go on describing Yadevi Sarvabhuteshu Matru Rupena Sanstita, existing in all the beings as the Mother, Dhariya, essence, Bala, strength, every possible human emotions, Kama, Irsha, every possible emotions. Desire, anger, jealousy, everything is divine. Sarvarupena Sanstita. That is why we see that, friends, your body has no sense of conflict, has no sense of limitation. It doesn't enjoy the childhood, youth, or old age. The body doesn't celebrate life, nor it is frightened of death. Your body, part of the same physical universe. The sense of aging, changing, please listen. The sense of aging, changing, doesn't exist in the creation. Only when you say, ahankar, the I thought comes in. To say, I am aging. Please see that, friends. You drag the changing, aging condition of the body. You feel growing, changing, dying. Body has no such feelings. Without this ahankar, aham karomi iti buddhi, I do, I live, I am young, I am old, without this I, dragging all the attributes towards itself, there is no frustration, fear, anxiety of any kind. And that is the Mahishasura, the demon looking like a buffalo. Buffalo stands for the darkness, ignorance and death. By its ignorance, it challenges the Mother, the God, the Goddess. That is its own source. It's like the child, helped to be grown up by the parents. But there is to destroy them. Or like anyone, tries to destroy something which has helped him to survive and grow. That is the asura. In ignorance, this buffalo-like demon tries to destroy all the devatas, fights with the universal Mother. It's like the ignorance born ahankar, I thought, ignoring consciousness, challenging the reality. With this knowledge of yourself, that way shines in all forms, in all possible ways, Yadevi, one with the Mother, the Absolute, the ignorance disappears, or surrenders, use whichever language you like. In the case of this knowledge, ahankar, call it surrendering to the Absolute, or being annihilated, both one and the same. Existing, it doesn't exist. You use the word I, even after the understanding of yourself, but it has no conflict. It's like the example we have seen. When a snake, the fangs are removed, it looks like a snake. It hisses with the hood expanded. Yet nobody is afraid of it when the fangs are removed. Same with this anger. Isolated because of ignorance, hisses at everybody because it is frightened. The hissing is not the strength of the snake, it is the sign of its fear and anxiety. The same snake, when it understands itself, when you see the root, it becomes an ornament around the neck of Shiva, an ayudha in the hands of Mother Durga, an instrument gently swaying in the body of Shiva. So see that. Yadevi sarvabhuteshu sarvarupena sansthita, in all the beings, a man or woman, a young or old, touchable, untouchable, animals, human beings, trees or stones, nobody escapes the touch and the embrace of the Divine. As you sit down here, I am talking to you. What I speak, these words, were thoughts. They were shining in the presence of awareness. The thoughts, when spoken, are heard by your ears. How do you hear? Again, you are conscious. What you hear becomes thoughts, and thoughts are illumined. the same awareness, in whose presence my thought comes, this body speaks. In the presence of same awareness, your ears, your body listens. Thoughts created, consciousness one and the same. Both for the speaker and listener, teacher and taught, seer and all that is seen. In every so-called apparent divisions, there is one indivisible, pure awareness. Call it Deva, Shiva, Mahadeva, Vishnu, Sabrahma, Sahari, Sendra. Call it Brahma, Indra, Akshara, Shiva. Or call it Shivani, Bhavani, Lakshmi, Durga, Saraswati. All one and the same. A tradition to be born to. See that yourself. Being one with yourself at all times, all places, in all conditions, my speech will stop. Your listening shall come to an end. My thoughts disappear. Your thoughts may disappear. Your thoughts may come to an end. You are always there. As much I am always there. See it right now, instantaneously. You cannot escape being yourself. Please do not lose yourself in words, descriptions, books, thoughts, ideas, even worships, practices. But see that every word is spoken. Every action is done. Every perception takes place. Every thought appears to disappear. All in the presence that is awareness, your sense of being, who you are. You can't escape being yourself. Listen carefully. Just see that and be that. Your thoughts you cannot hold on to. Your thoughts your memories, all these impressions in the mind, thought modifications, you cannot hold on to, they shall disappear, self-dismissing, and you cannot escape being the consciousness yourself, because nothing can dismiss it, nothing can cover it. So see that for yourself. Thereafter it is your choice whether to need, use a word to see the meaning, or just to be yourself. You don't need any word whatsoever. Life being what it is, since continuously the body is growing, changing, perceptions are taking place, memories continuously appearing to disappear, reminding you of various things, various experiences of the past, projecting into future. Chances are, sometimes you may lose track of yourself. That is why consciously dwell on yourself. You can do so without depending on a word or a form. You can also do so taking into account all forms in this universe. When it comes to God called Ishvara, Deva, Devi, as we have seen, it's not one name or one form, but all forms exist in it. Like body is not a name for a form, in a limited way, we see that. But it's the name for all the limbs in the body. It's a hand, is one part, leg, thighs, stomach, nose. Each name points out a part. But when you say body, it includes all the parts. So every part, first it is the body, then it is something else. The beauty of it is, friends, when you say the universe, the whole physical universe, your body is already included in that, is existing. I hope you see that point. don't have to say body and the hand. Don't have to say universe and the body. It's already a part of the creation. That is why body has no sense of separation from the universe. It has no sense of living, has no sense of dying. It's a presence. No body, nothing stands apart from totality. Samasti, Ishwara. Long before you are even aware of it, you are one with it. Take these statements, friends. Long before you are even aware of it, you are already one with it. Ishavasyam idam sarva. The whole universe, the creation, is to be seen Ishavuddhyacharanyam as the manifestation. God alone is, call it truth, Deva Devi. So that Sarvabhuteshu is shining in all the beings, in all the forms. You look at yourself. What is that is shining in your body, your mind? The body is something which you have. It belongs to the universe. Call it Ishwara. The Virat, the totality. Your mind, your thoughts, again part of the totality. Everything that you have belongs to Ishwara, the totality. Who you are is one with totality, Ishwara. What you have belongs to Ishwara. Call it Mother, call it Deva, call it Devi. But who you are is one with the existence. Name it Devi, Deva, or whatever form you like. Brahman, masculine, feminine, neuter. Where the ignorance, as though creating a disturbance, like the demon, buffalo-like demon, symbolizing ignorance. Yet, that ignorance also is not hated in our tradition. Ajnanaya namaha. That ajnana also is my namaskar. Without ignorance, without sense of individuality, without the sense of mortality, you shall not experience this beautiful universe. Without the sense of individuality, there shall not be any conflict. For you to resolve it, only human beings strive for liberation. The trees, animals, every other little manifestations, they have no sense of conflict, therefore no sense of resolution, no sense of bondage. Therefore, they don't enjoy the sense of freedom. So see things as they are. First, seeing the presence as yourself, Yadevi Sarvabhuteshu Sarvarupena Sansthita Matru Rupena Sansthita Shakti Rupena Sansthita Dhairya Rupena Sansthita in every possible emotions, every little thing that is existing. It's nothing but the manifestation of the same absolute shining effulgence existence. That is why that verse, when you go to Mukambika or any Devi temple, they go on chanting Sarva Mangala Mangali Shive Sarvartha Sadhiki Sharanye Trayambike Devi Narayani Namastute. O Mother, to you Te Namaha Astu. To you my Namaskar. Namaskar means they are totally disappear. Namami, know me, I fall. I disappear. I no more exist. That is why prostrations, a symbolic representation. You can't say body and the nose, India and Tamil Nadu, Earth and India, universe and solar system, and doesn't exist. Nor can you say God and I. You can say king and I, president and I, but you can't say God, and there is no and there. It is he, she, it. To him, to her, my namaskar, namostu, because you are sarva mangala mangali. You are the auspiciousness of all kinds. There is no sense of limitation of any kind in a limitless expanse. Unless you isolate the part and lose sight of the whole, lose sight of the totality, there is no amangala, no inauspiciousness, no end, no death, no limitations. So, Mother, you are the auspiciousness, Shive. So call it Shiva, call it Shiva, Shiva the masculine, Shiva the feminine, so Shive, O Mother, the auspiciousness. Sarvartha sadhiki, dharma, artha, kama, moksha. Everything is in you, Sarvartha-sadhiki. One who holds on to you, aware of himself, herself, at once you get chaturvarga, dharma, artha, kama, moksha. Everything that you do, everything that you speak, everything that you have, everything that you wish, that is the artha, that is the kama, that is the dharma, that is the moksha. That is the absolute reality which you saw the other class, dharma, dharma, vivarjita. Beyond right and wrong, beyond good and bad, beyond vice and virtue. That is why when you read Mother's thousand names, Nishpapa, Papanasini, Nirmoha, Mohanasini, where there is no delusion, no right, no wrong, no papa, no punya. Yet it destroys every limitation also. Saranya, you are the only one, Saranya, you are the one, Sarana Yogya, only point, only one in which somebody can find his refuge. Nowhere, if you look for refuge, you shall ever be saved, in a sense. If you take refuge in money, position, image, goodness, badness, you cannot be protected, because where you are trying to find your refuge itself, self-annihilating. You take refuge in your body, the body will disappear, fade away. You take refuge in your thought, the thoughts shall disappear. You take refuge in a man or woman, they shall disappear. You take refuge in good work, bad work, both will come to an end. You take refuge in anything, if it's a thing away from totality, it will come to an end. O Mother, you are the only refuge. Meaning thereby, Ya Devi, the consciousness, call it Deva, call it Devi, that is the only refuge. Being one with it, no more there is sense of loss, helplessness, fear, limitation, or anxiety. Saranya, Trayambike Devi. You are Trayambike, three eyes, like Shiva has got Trinetradhari, three eyes. The two eyes standing for perception, the third for the knowledge, Chakshusha Chakshu, eye of the eyes, Mother also, three eyes. O Devi, Narayani Namastute, Narayana, Narayani, Narasyayam Naram Teshamayana, meaning that which is the supreme goal of every individual. The one universal, supreme goal of every individual. Absolute happiness, fulfillment, immortality, beyond the limitations of all kind. Nothing else is everybody's goal. Swimming, climbing a mountain, singing, dancing, thousand different professions, pot making, you name it, or even these practices, fire ritual, physical austerities, denials, indulgence, nothing is everybody's cup of tea. There is no such thing where anybody can find refuge. Nothing shall protect. That cannot be the supreme goal of anything. Whereas yourself, who you are, everybody wants immortality, sat, chit, ananda, all knowledge, bliss, fulfillment. Immortality. And that is in yourself. Narayana. namastute to that. Namo astu to you, mother. Prostrations. So these days, look at the richness of the tradition. Mother worship, or worship Shiva. So many festivities, Vishnu, so many festivities, Ganesha, Rama, trees, animals, human beings. Separated, you are so limited. Together, you are the absolute. Separated, a drop is a drop. Together, the same drop gains the oceanness. Understand? Body doesn't separate you from the universe. The thoughts do not separate you from God. It is the I, the individuality. Because body has no sense of separation. Your thoughts have no sense of separation. Your perceptions, sensations have no sense of separation. Renunciation or indulgence, it is the I. So that I surrenders. Namostute, O Lord. You can't do namaskar to God without losing yourself. How will you become totality? If you are still standing as somebody, see that, just to be yourself, you don't need my speech, you don't need a thought, you don't need the I thought. Nothing is needed. But there is no such thing which you cannot live with. There is no such thing which you cannot give up. Live without. That is the glory. It's like in water. The whole ocean is existing. Yet water doesn't need an ocean to exist. Doesn't need a wave to exist. To be yourself, you don't need anything, yet there is no such thing with which you cannot live. You can live with your body, your mind, your thoughts, your memories, the limitations of every kind, because you are limitless. Yet no limitations touch you. There is no need to talk, to think. To do or not to do. To be who you are. Just be that.